My name is Sean Glebel, and I'm here doing a Matrix exhibition at the Wadsworth. I started off like any kid, just drawing, and I never really stopped. Actually, the earliest piece that I have at this in this show is called Line Work, and I started the project in 2000, and I always saw this project like a kind of video drawing. Myself with a handy cam on a skateboard, just tracing lines like street markings. And that's probably the start of like a whole series of experiments in video as a way of just looking at the differences between lines on a road. It's very simple. I always quote Paul Klee. His notion of drawing was like taking a line for a walk. I really love that idea that I'm just doing a kind of rolling version of that. And I wanted to connect what I did on the weekends to what I was doing at art school, and that's where most of this work is inspired. You know, I was interested in extreme sports and the way that people move through cities, the ways that bodies relate to space. The latest work that I have here is called Pacific Undertow, which is a video of a surfer upside down, but the camera's been reversed and corrected. So it looks like they're kind of just sitting on their surfboard waiting for a wave. This is a kind of an interesting thing for me, for there to be effects that happen in camera, that there's no CGI, there's no manipulation of the image, just beyond a very simple manipulation, whether that be slow motion, inverting the camera, framing it in a different way, like in the line work pieces. So it's all about using the materials in a very simple, direct, straightforward way. The idea that the video is kind of like really long, it's like one take, there's not much editing. Sometimes the pieces are silent, they don't have any soundtracks at all. These are all things that I'm interested in when I think of certainly the history of moving image making. There are two works in this show that come from like a series that I called Mattus Maximus, which was like a whole group of works I shot in Central Australia. And they kind of connected, I guess, mostly to Mad Max 2, you know, this kind of film that was shot in this very particular location in far western New South Wales in Australia. So my take on it was to rethink those locations using some of the props that in the film. Like the one that's happening behind me is using the car from Mad Max, the Interceptor. So I built a replica of that car and went out to the location that Mad Max was shot in, and I staged these performances that are really simple, very subtle, nothing really going on in terms of action, just figures crawling from the inside to the outside of the car. So they're basically just car surfing. Seriality and repetition is something that I'm interested in well before it became like a kind of theme, say, in pop art. I like these older examples of people looking and then re-looking, which is certainly what's happening in this piece. There's the same gesture, the same figure is getting out of the same car, but in one instance it's like in the middle of the day, and the other scene there's this kind of huge storm cloud gathering over the top, and you can sort of see this rain falling in the distance. There's three different figures and they're spinning in different ways, so it's like a piece where I'm kind of cataloging these different bodies spinning. And I like the idea that they're all from different kind of movement languages or from different subcultures, and that they're all involved in this kind of similar kind of activity. They're kind of like different prosthetics in a way. You know, the stilts, the crutches and the skateboard, they're kind of ways of extending the capacity of the body. And in this case, I'm just presenting a photograph of a figure who's kind of in a landscape, who's balancing a gun. But I was interested in a work that responded to the collection here, because of course Samuel Colt has had quite an influence in this museum, as he has within the whole kind of Hartford community. And I did some research and found out that the gun that I was photographing with this soldier in this particular photo was a Colt M4, which is a gun that the US military are using. The figure is performing with the gun and sort of considering it in some dysfunctional way, or finding like a kind of para function, like a different function for this gun. The gun's not used for its designed sort of deadly sort of purposes. It's kind of being used as a kind of balancing rod or pole or something. This particular piece is just like a figure that rides along highways and addresses roadkill kangaroos. But it's kind of a tough one to talk about, because I think that you got to really just see the work. I mean, it's just great to be exhibiting with the Matrix program, I guess. I like the history of the show. It was definitely worth the trip out here.